In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you.
And with your spirit.
Please be seated for the liturgy.
Who have led us the will of my Father, the land of the kingdom of heaven, my Lord. My song is mercy and justice. I sing to you your word. I will walk in the way of perfection. For when and where do you come?
I will walk in a dangerous heart, within my house. I will not set before my eyes whatever is face.
I will take the ways of the crooked. They shall not be my friends. The false hearted must be far away. The wicked by his own.
The man's heart is the same word as his head. I will remain in silence. The man of brows and a broken heart. I will never endure.
I look to the faithful in the land, that they may dwell with me. He who walks in the way of perfection shall be my friend.
Who prepares
my hands for war.
He is my love. But your light means throughout the whole, through the hours and the light of light. Reach down from heaven and save me. Throw me out from the mighty waters, from the hands of the alien hosts, whose mouths are filled with lies, whose hands are raised with perjury. To you, O God, will I sing a new song. I will pray the next three times. To you, will be the victory, who set me with your servant free. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as he was in the beginning, now and will be forever. Amen. Lord, God of strength, you gave your Son victory over death, the record shares fight against evil in the world. Clothe us in the weapons of light, and unite us under the one banner of love, that we may see our eternal reward after the battle of earthly life. The Lord is my refuge and my Savior.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that celebrating the mysteries of the Lord's resurrection, we may merit to receive the joy of our redemption through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. They who had been scattered from persecution that arose because of Stephen went as far as Phoenicia, Cyprus, and Antioch, preaching the word to no one but Jews. There were some Cypriots and Cyrenians among them, however, who came to Antioch and began to speak to the Greeks as well, proclaiming the Lord Jesus. The hand of the Lord was with them, and a great number of believers turned to the Lord. The news about them reached the ears of the church in Jerusalem, and they sent Barnabas to go to Antioch. When he arrived and saw the grace of God, he rejoiced and encouraged them all to remain faithful to the Lord in pureness of heart. For he was a good man, filled with the Holy Spirit and faith. And a large number of people was added to the Lord. Then he went to Tarsus to look for Saul, and when he had found him, he brought him to Antioch. For a whole year they met in church and taught a large number of people, and it was in Antioch that the disciples were first called Christians. The word of the Lord. All you nations, praise the Lord.
All you nations, praise the Lord.
His foundation upon the holy mountains, the Lord loves. The gates of Zion, more than any dwelling of Jacob. Glorious things have said of you, O city of God.
All you nations, praise the Lord.
I tell of Egypt and Babylon, among those who know the Lord, of Philistia, Tyre, Ethiopia. This man was born there. And of Zion, they shall say, one and all were born in her, and he who established her is the Most High Lord.
All nations, praise the Lord.
They shall know when the peoples are enrolled. This man was born there, and all shall see in their festive dance, my home is within you.
All nations, praise the Lord.
Please all stand.
Hallelujah.
feast of dedication was taking place in Jerusalem. It was winter, and Jesus walked about the temple area on the portico of Solomon. So the Jews gathered around him and said to him, "How long are you going to keep us in suspense? If you are the Christ, tell us plainly." Jesus answered them, "I told you, and you do not believe. The works I do in my Father's name testify to me, but you do not believe, because you are not among my sheep. My sheep hear my voice. I know them, and they follow me. I give them eternal life, and they shall never perish. No one can take them out of my hand. My Father who has given them to me is greater than all, and no one can take them out of the Father's hand. The Father and I are one." Let us go to all the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Can you give a smile to the people around you saying, "Mayang buntag"? Of, you know, enculturation, adaptation, accommodation to the language of the people and the culture of the people. I would like to emphasize today my reflection about the importance of, as I've said, shepherding. And one of the elements of, to me, to do a better shepherding is listening. My dear friends, Jesus explains that to the Jews in the Gospel today who are asking him if he is the Christ. And he told them, I told you and you do not believe the words I do in my Father's name, testify me to me, but you do not believe because you are not among my sheep. My sheep hear my voice. And so first, listening to the voice of the Lord is a source of good shepherding. This, like reading, you know, the source of this listening and the readings of the scriptures is very important when we catechism priests do our regular readings of the scriptures. And I do this before I begin to, by hiking or driving or saying the Mass. Or I can also listen to the voice of the Lord through sitting down with people and listening to their beautiful stories. But sometimes I hear the complaints of the old folks because they said to me, or I hear that from other people telling me, I have no time to listen to them because I am always in a hurry to set out for the next assignment because I have still to hike for another Mass schedule to the other DEC. So, hindi nila wala ng time, Father. And so I really put that in my heart that sitting down and listening to the people's stories is kind of a good shepherding. Second aspect of good shepherding is knowing the sheep. Deed of mission, my previous assignment, actually this is my first assignment when I went to, when I was incarcerated from the Lao to Northern Luzon during the time of Bishop Cleburne. I was accepted there, was incarcerated, and was ordained there in the year 2007. And so my 10th year anniversary as a priest is this coming May 24. So I hope you can come, no? Because it's a thanksgiving after all my experiences working with the people there in the mountains. I'm still alive. But the message is not hospital because of the difficult, you know, hikings, sabi ng doctor, that dehydrate ka, you drink a lot of water. And also driving is a very stressful, no? Work. Kasi, kaya, hospital na po, kontaktong work ako, mabuhay pa ako, kapat, sana mabuhay pa. And so, I mentioned this, you know, Tikut Mission, my previous assignment, has 16 DECs. And 8 of these DECs can be reached by hiking. It starts with 1 hour, 2 hours, 5 hours, 7 hours, and the farthest is Abat DEC, which is 12 hours hike. You start at 6 a.m. and you arrive at 6 p.m. And you, and I have to pass 14 hanging bridges. And the last hanging bridge is already dangerous kasi naputol na at nakalawa na. Sabi ko sa iba, huwag kayong susunod at muna mauna. Palaasi yun. Pero sa ito, pag palaasi. Kasi kung maputol, wala bang ibang daan ito? Pwede bang sa ilalim na lang doon sa river? But it is mataas. Kaya you have to pass through that last bridge, the hanging bridge, in order to see the people. So, yun ang aking karanasan. And I said this to you, not to impress you, my dear brothers and sisters, because most of us miss catechists there, and all of us who are assigned in the mountains are doing this, walking, hiking for a number of hours. So even if it's too far, I need to walk for one day, I have to walk in order to meet these people, the remote, the people who are in the remote areas, so that they can avail the Holy Eucharist and other sacraments. And it is advantage on my part that I became a catechist before becoming a priest. Ay, hinanda ako ng Diyos siguro, because when I studied Tomorrow Flight, I was one of the six catechists assigned in Mountain Province. Noong panahon ngayon, buhay pa si Bishop Ibigan, saka si Father Pong Bumabong yung kumuha sa amin. And so I said to the Miss Tomorrow Flight, I want to be assigned here. It looks like Bukidnon. It looks like Bukidnon. So, yung mga miss sabi na, sige, dito pa masang. And when I arrived there, I was happy. And, you know, napalapit ako sa kanilang kultura. Their culture is so wonderful and mysterious. Kasi sa Bukidnon, di ko alam my culture. I do not know my culture because I came from there. My lolo came from Visayas, from Bohol, and originally they said that they came from Cebu. So I was really amazed by the culture of people. And so, yun ang umpisa na nahuli ang puso ko. Actually, I want to get buried there, no? Because, you know, Igoros or Igoros are beautiful women, like long. sorry. Yeah, that's true. Matalina, 69, you know? So I attracted to these people not only because of their faces, but most especially because of their culture. So, yun, nag-send ako doon. Itinuloy ko ang aking pag-imong ex-seminarian at kasi nung nag-aral ko sa mga flight, ex-seminarian ito ba? Doon ko lang ang tinuloy. Sabi pa ni Bishop Bigbigan, if you want to be a priest, then go back to your diocese in Pito, in Malinaray. He said, I want to serve the people here in the Cordillera. So, in God's grace, and in God's calling, natupad yun at na-ordain ang doon sa Monte Province. So, better, my dear brothers and sisters, to continue, you know, after reaching this part-time base, it's like busy, like Abba, 12 hours flight. After all the perspiration, sabi ko, malapit naman, malapit naman sa langit. Nangangawin ang akin pa, lalo na yung first tayo yung naglakad doon, nag-diretso-diretso. Gabi na kami dumating. At nung pagdating doon, ang daming mga tao pala. Kinabukasan, sabi ko, nung umaga na, ano na mga tao dito? Wala na mga bahay. Sabi nila, nanggaling pa sila pare sa malalayo. Naglakad pa sila ng 2 hours in order to see you. You see? And that's my consolation, my brothers and sisters. My consolation is to see the joyful faces of the people waiting for the priests. And next to that, my other consolation is, of course, to eat the naked chicken, naked pork, root crabs, and ekamote, and saging mais. So talagang busog na busog ako. That's my consolation. After the Mass, before the Mass, sabi naman tao, Father, before the Mass, can you still hear confession? So, katapos ko ng misa, nananatong ng misa, my God, ang offering, isang sakong kamuti. Sabi nila, Father, you bring with you this kamuti. For 2 hours, carry that. No joke, sabi nila, joke lang, Father. Ang ginawa nila, hinati-hati ng apat na tao kamuti. Saging, panis, ano-ano pa, gulay, pati manok. Kaya yung manok, natawitan sa Ilocano, Prosper, hindi ko pinarating, hindi ko kinatay. Kasi, remembrance ko na, inuha ko yung manok sa 12 hours at inabi ko siya sa tulugan ko. Yun ang naging alarm clock ko. Amen?
Amen.
Gusto mo umiyak kasi mainit pa, malayo